What sort of injuries and medical issues did most of the people that you saw have?
We saw children with open wounds on their faces. We saw a baby with jaundice. We saw many adults with injuries from what appeared to be blast injuries, open wounds, fractures. Unfortunately, the hospital has such limited staffing, is unable to provide care to a lot of those people. So even basic pain management is difficult or impossible in many circumstances. We saw children holding IV fluid bags for their brothers and sisters and for their parents. We saw blood all over the floors. It looked almost like a battlefield hospital that's just obviously completely overwhelmed with a constant inflow of new patients, ambulances arriving, constantly people being brought in on donkey carts, on trolleys. We even had people walking alongside our vehicles, pushing patients on stretchers. It was hard to imagine.
And what sort of conversations were the doctors and those nurses who are treating the many, many injured at the hospital having with you?
They said they're overwhelmed. They said that they need everything. I mean, we're constantly asked what the priorities are, and it's a very challenging question for a place like Shifa, because they don't have fuel to run their generators. They don't have oxygen. They don't have medicines to care for the patients. They don't have staff to even clean wounds and provide basic pain management. So they said that they need everything. And also almost every single person who approached us asked us for food and water. There's a desperate need of everything, but people are really hungry and they're really thirsty. But what the staff also said to us, which was really moving, is that they're committed to helping their people.